Welcome to Geekonomics. Marc and Bryon in his house. As the kids say, oh, a little music interlude there. Back at it with another edition of Geekonomics. How you doing, Bryon?
Good. How are you,
Did you have
Marc?
A good week?
I had a good week.
It was a big weekend for nerds and sports fans alike. We had the
McGregor, finale. Ewan McGregor, and the...
Ewan McGregor and Lee Merriweather fought each other.
No, it was Ewan McGregor versus Anakin Skywalker.
Oh, is that what it was?
Fight.
I thought it was Lee Merriweather and Ewan McGregor.
Ewan McGregor and...
Lee Merriweather.
Anna Skywalker.
Anakin Skywalker.
Anakin Skywalker.
Anna Skywalker.
And I heard that Anakin Skywalker lost because...
Ewan McGregor had the high ground.
Yeah, Ewan McGregor had the high ground.
Yeah.
And once you have the high ground...
There's no defeating you.
Yeah. He tried to... He thought
Unless
he was,
you have like a flying dragon that breathes blue fire.
Yeah.
And then you don't have a high ground.
Anna McGregor thought he could do
Ewan
kicks.
McGregor.
No, Anna. And then you...
What is wrong
I'm changing
you?
It now. So Anna McGregor jumps. Even though he has a low ground, Ewan McGregor just... His hand turned into a lightsaber and just cut off his legs and left him to die. I think he's still laying there dying right now.
Probably is.
As we're recording this.
Probably is.
But he got paid like $75 million to die.
Well, Senator Palpatine's going to come pick him up and fix him and turn him into Darth Lanigan.
Dark Lanigan.
Dark Lanigan.
And they're going to have another...
They're going to have another fight.
Another fight.
And then he's going to win because he's going to kill...
Well, be half robot. I mean...
Kenobi, so that's it.
Have you ever had a robot fight in...
Boxing?
Well, then yes, they're going to turn Ewan McGregor into a robot. It's become a whole thing.
It's going to turn into a thing. It's going to be a never-ending story.
Humans versus robots.
Terminator. Skynet is active.
So that happened. That match happened.
That was great, though. It was great.
People like 10 rounds?
I think so. I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? You know everything about sports. The word sport is in it. Marc Warnock knows it.
That's true. I do keep my tabs on the sports world, as they say.
Your phone's like blowing up.
I know, it's clear.
What happened? What did you do? Did you not take the dog out?
No, she was asking why I didn't stop by and say I had to run away into work today. I said because Bryon's a whiny biatch and has to go to work early.
Actually, I'm supposed to be at work right now.
Oh, breaking the rules. Breaking the law. Bump, bump, bump.
Well, Marc, why didn't you stop and say hi?
Because you had to go to work, so I had to come here. Didn't have time.
And we were locked out.
And we were locked out, so I had to get here and push through the door. Use my strength.
You hodored it.
My hodor. I had to hodor it.
Right through that wall.
Right through the door. And I had to hodor to make sure you can get in.
So, yes, I finally finished Doctor Who and Game of Thrones. So we'll talk about that last. Something I wanted to talk about last week, we didn't get a chance to.
Or in other words, Bryon forgot about it.
I did forget about it, actually.
Yeah, that's what it really
was. I remembered after the fact.
Yeah, which is usually the better show. The after show when Bryon remembers everything you want to talk about.
Yeah.
Oh, I want to talk about it. And I want to talk about it.
I think you yammered on so long about your vacation. I kind of like fell asleep and forgot everything
you
I wanted to talk about.
You asked me about it. You jerk.
I was like,
I took a nap.
And then I woke up.
You know what? From now on, I won't tell you anything about myself. How about that? Asshole.
I'm only kidding.
You dink.
So, you dink. MoviePass is interesting.
Oh, yes. Tell me about this MoviePass idea. This sounds fantastic.
So, this has been around for a couple years now.
I'll take a nap.
This MoviePass has been around. It was $50 a month.
Whoa. That's crazy.
So, they came out and said, we're
not making any money.
They haven't. They're losing money.
So, you know what we should do?
Go down to 10.
We're going to knock this down to $10.
Yeah. What a deal, huh?
What a steal.
So, their president is saying, listen, Netflix is doing it. And it's successful. We want to change the way people go to the movies. And this potentially could bring in more people. But the problem is, what's it, the AMC. Now, listen. These movie theaters aren't losing money. This is how it works. You get the movie pass. You have to put it on your phone, right? You sign up. So you pay $10 a month. Now, if you go to two movies, you can only go to one movie a day with it. You can't go to two movies in one day.
Why would you do that anyway?
Also, I think it only counts for...
What is that kind of time?
You can't see the same movie.
Oh, you can see it once and that's it?
Yeah.
Oh.
This is how... And you can't... You would have to pay extra for 3D or IMAX.
Oh. Well, it's not like there's been like a movie that I've wanted to see more than once besides Force Awakens anyway.
Fair enough.
So, the only one I ever saw four times in one weekend was that movie.
Yeah, me, same here.
Last Jedi will probably be the next one. But.
So the movie pass for moviegoers that go a lot, this is an awesome, awesome deal. So there's some interesting things about this, though. So you put it on your phone, and then when you go up and you have to go online and you say, I want to see whatever movie, Jumbo emoji to whatever. You click it. You sign up for it. Okay. You go to your theater. They scan it. That theater is still getting the money. It's like invisible money. Yeah. They scan it. They get
like
their...
Like everything else in the world is invisible money.
They get their $12 or whatever.
Just like an ATM card.
But it gets to the company doing the movie pass, and you're just paying the $10. The savings are on to you. So these theaters aren't losing anything. They're paying out, but they're losing money.
Yeah.
But so this is where it gets dicey. Mm. So I don't think I would ever sign up for one because I go to the movies like maybe once a month or maybe every less than that. So for me,
it's not like you're making.
I might be donating $10 a month
for a person that goes like my coworker goes to the movies like every other week to see a new movie.
It's perfect.
It's great for that. But if you're a person like us who only goes to,
you go to the movies a lot, don't you?
Well, just the superhero movies.
Yeah,
and a sporadic movie here and there that might pop up, but nothing like.
So,
but even still, like the way it's for me,
it's a good deal. But
it's a great deal. But the thing now is like with the way movies are going. And they're churning through them so quickly in the theaters.
Yeah.
Like, Guardians of the Galaxy, we just saw, when did it come out?
May.
It's out on DVD now.
Yeah, it was the first movie of the summer for us.
And even Logan's out, been out already.
Oh, well, Logan came out in February.
Yeah, but I'm saying, so I mean, like, those movies are already out in theaters, or already out on, like, Blu-ray.
Yeah.
So you either
turn around.
May, or you wait
4 months.
4 months for movies that
June, July, August.
On the fringe. And like,
honestly, it's a little over 3 months.
Yeah.
And you know what's also weird?
And they're on DVR and everything right away, too, now, because it shows up on your DVR.
What was the Star Trek?
You can watch this, buy this now.
Last summer, we saw the Star Trek movie.
Yeah.
It's on TV.
Yeah.
It was just on TV this weekend on like Sony Classics or Epics or one of those.
Deadpool was already on like HBO and everything, so it's just.
Well, Deadpool's over a year.
It goes pretty quick. Yeah, it's not.
Turnaround is quick now. You're right. I agree.
Yeah.
But anyway, if you go to the theater a lot, it's a great deal.
Yeah.
The caveat to all this is the company that went after MoviePass to save them. So it's a date. Now, they've come out and said this. They're transparent. You can look this up. They're not trying to hoodwink people. It's a data mining company.
Mm.
This data mining company, I don't know the name. They're the ones who said, we will give you all this money. So when you sign up for MoviePass, you give them all your information. They know what movies you're seeing, what times,
what kind of stuff you're buying while you're at the movie theater.
They don't know that yet.
Well,
concession. They don't know concession.
I know, but they know like what your tight taste in movies is.
Yes,
and what
they know what you're seeing. They know if you live in Hartford, if you're seeing urban-oriented movies, you're seeing cartoons.
Yeah,
this is big. Like,
and then they start like sending you the ads for those movies that come out.
Nobody knows what this data mining company is going to do with this, but this is big.
That's what they're going to do. It's going to sell it back to the movie companies, and they're going to say, "Oh, okay, Jimmy Johnson over here goes to all those Marvel movies."
Well, it's not going to be one person. It's going to be a collective.
That's what I'm saying, but you know what I mean? Like, because they have your email address. They have all the information. So when those movies come out, they'll hit you with an email. Like, don't forget, you know, coming out. The new Avengers is coming out.
This data mining company is going to sell your information.
You see, you like this movie that's lesser known is coming out. You might also enjoy this as well. Or, hey, Chris Evans is in this movie. Is in Avengers. Hey, Chris Evans is also in this movie. You might want to go check this out.
Well, not only that, Mark.
Because those will pop up on your movie pass. Those little ads.
What I'm getting at, they could potentially sell this up to movie production houses for information.
Yeah.
No, you're talking about advertisement. I'm not even talking about that. I'm saying they could potentially sell this information to say, listen, we have a movie coming out. We might only put that movie out in certain locations because we know it's going to do very well.
Yeah.
And skip the other locations. We know it's not going to do well because of this information. That's how I'm seeing it.
That's,
I mean,
like, that's,
they could do anything with
I
this
know,
information.
But that's like them, like a movie company doing that. It's just
they do it now. I mean,
well, they got the select cities thing, but it's always like the major cities it's in. It's not in like the
no, that's
cities.
Not what I'm talking about. Like art houses get independent. Now you're going straight. We have so many straight to digital now. It's unbelievable. Oh, yeah. Now they can say, listen, we know this movie's not going to do well. Don't even put it in the theater straight to digital. Or
well, it's this probably a good idea for some movies. Like some movies just shouldn't be released at all.
It could be. It could go out.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, if you sign, you're getting them your information.
And there's some movies I wish were that way when I was younger, like Jury Duty. I wish I never had to worry about seeing that.
Well, why would you see that in the theater?
I don't know. Just someone accidentally went to see it because they thought it might be good.
Yeah. Well, hey, it all happens.
And then walk out halfway through. Demand your money back. Stuff like that.
So, yeah, it's very interesting. Now, I don't really know if this company is going to last, but
I mean, it's like is it a well-known thing that people are out there, like, everyone's going out and getting? Like, I know
Their sales went up.
Yeah.
Big time. Their stocks went up. Their sales went up.
Do you think, like, honestly, do you think it's a lot of grandparents buying this? Like,
no.
Older folks buying it and being like,
no.
Oh, that's where I could take my grandkids, because it's kind of
they can't take
thought.
Somebody, though.
No, I'm saying, like, buy more than one pass.
Then you're paying $20 a month.
Yeah.
That's silly.
Well,
you're not buying it for someone. You're buying it for yourself. No, a lot of people in industry who see movies and review them, they're buying this because
why don't you get it for free if you're
a lot of people. A lot of people reviewers don't get it for free. They have to pay.
Seems weird. They want to get a
especially if you're like an online reviewer. You're not going to go for free.
I would have hooked up something with my local movie theater in that case. I'd been like, hey, I review movies. You guys let me in for free, y'all.
I don't think
a little spot.
Like, I don't think they don't see the word Siskel or Ebert. They don't care.
Well, I don't think they see either of them anymore because they're both dead. So
both of them are dead.
Yes.
Siskel and Ebert.
Yes.
You know who I just heard of who died?
God.
Jerry Lewis died. I thought he was dead. I thought he was dead for like the last 10 years.
No, he died like last week.
Wow. I thought he was already dead.
Nope.
God. It was like a poof.
Yeah.
He's like, Jerry Lewis is dead? Oh, I thought he's been dead.
Yeah. Like Don Rickles. Don Rickles passed
away. I knew he died, and that was sad. Jerry Lewis, I could care less about.
Well, he was sick. That's why he wasn't like, he wasn't out in the public eye like Rickles was.
Jerry Lewis, he was mentally sick. I know that.
Well, I mean, he had other things.
He was a fucking little loony bin.
Well, it happens.
But anyway, Jerry Lewis died.
Yes.
Everybody.
Siskel and Ebert? Love how you get like a question like you're asking, like I'm lying to you, like I have stashed in a back room somewhere.
Wait, really? Are you like Oprah and you're gonna bring them out?
But no, they're really right here right now. Siskel and Ebert, come on out.
Hey, two thumbs up.
I brought him back for the dead just to review your movie.
Anyway, MoviePass, it ultimately is a fantastic deal for us, and if I saw movies, I would definitely get it. But
well, so, that guy from WWLP. What? If I saw his name on a movie and he said he liked it, I'd listen to him. Cy Becker, and let him look at the movies.
He's cross-eyed, so I really question
but he's
his...
He's still alive, though. I thought he was dead.
No, he's alive.
He's still alive.
I question if
I've moved
he can actually see the
Springfield
movies.
Now, and I see WLP again, and I'm like, oh, my crap.
The worst news.
Cy Becker's still alive?
I hate Channel 22. This is the worst.
I hate it, too. The only reason why I have to watch the tail end of it is because you got to get... Because the ABC Western Mass News ends before they do. And I switch to it to get to Jimmy Fallon, and I get like the tail end.
Yeah,
and I'm like,
another
look all of you.
At the movies.
All three of you people.
Even though I'm staring at a wall and your face,
the doofy weather guy.
So here's the other thing, though. So AMC has come out and said this is not good for the industry.
Well, no,
and here's why.
People aren't buying tickets from them.
No, because AMC's still making
money.
They're not losing money from this. It's winning.
But they're not getting the money directly.
No, this is why. They came out. This is what they said.
Okay.
AMC's still getting paid. Like I told you. MoviePass is losing money.
I got you.
They're losing money.
Okay.
This whole thing.
If you say so.
This is everything I've read and watched. AMC is making their money. Everybody's making their money. The president of AMC does not like this business model because then... If someone were to say, listen, I'm buying a ticket for $13, and they go, well, why am I paying $13 when I can get MoviePass and I pay $10 for the month? And if that, just like Netflix and Best Buy. So Best Buy, not Best Buy, Blockbuster, if you go, well, with Netflix, I pay $10 a month and I can rent all the movies I want. Mm. And why would I go to Blockbuster and pay $4 each movie and a late fee? Why would I do that? So that if MoviePass, they're afraid if MoviePass becomes so successful and it gets ingrained that movies are only worth $10 a month in the theater, this could ruin a business model.
Well, it's not even $10 a month. It's $10 just to go.
Yes, but if they're saying if people value...
So if you watch more than one movie a month, you're pretty much going for free the rest of the month.
Yeah, but if they devalue something...
That's what I'm saying.
...enough, AMC is looking at this like you could just fuck up the system here because a movie is worth X amount of dollars.
Well, they say it's worth that amount of money.
I agree. If you think about how much money it takes to make a movie...
$13 to go to a movie... I'm paying you basically the
on Tuesdays it's $6.
Not all the places. All the places don't do that anymore.
Yeah, but I disagree.
But I'm paying you $13.
But how much? How much?
You to press a not even to press a button anymore. It's all run by a computer.
Yeah, but how much money? How much money was it to make that movie?
It's not my fault.
See, this is the attitude. This is exactly.
I don't. Why do you need to? It's not my fault. You spent a bazillion dollars on your movie.
I'm not saying. But what about the independent movies that don't spend a bazillion dollars? How do they make their money back?
Making a good movie?
How would you know until you see it? That's not a good one.
You could still put $100 million into a movie.
Yeah.
No matter if it's a big movie and, say, a small movie, you put in, like, $2 or $3 million.
So you don't think it's worth paying $13 to see it?
But if you're a good movie, it shouldn't matter what the price of the ticket is.
But you just said it did. And how would you know until you see it?
Exactly.
So I don't get your
But argument. Word of mouth hurts it more than a ticket would. Well, if you go to a movie.
Not always.
If you go to the movie.
Not word of mouth always.
No, but if you go to the movie, say like a Green Lantern.
Yeah.
You go to the movie.
Yeah.
And
I paid my $13.
You pay $13.
Yeah.
And you go halfway through it, you walk out because it was bad.
Yeah.
Which you did.
Yeah.
And you go and tell your friends or whoever. God, that movie was fucking awful.
But that didn't stop a lot of people from seeing it. Batman vs. Superman got totally wrecked before coming out, and it did buco buck.
Yeah. Well, because people are dumb.
Well, no. Because this is why Transformers movies lasted, and they're all horrible in my opinion, but a lot of people like them. A movie is subjective no matter
Trump
what.
Is president.
No. Movies are subjective. If you don't like them or like them,
but still,
for
but
every movie you hate, there's 10 people who like them.
You can still say there's tons of movies that they make for $3 million or $100 million.
Yeah.
And you're not getting your money back. Like Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
Was a huge amount of money, and they didn't even get close to making it back.
Well, maybe in foreign sales they did. I don't know.
But I'm saying, like, originally, the thought process was they weren't going to make the money back.
Yeah.
So if they paid $10 for a ticket, if they paid $13 for a ticket... There's not much of a...
I'm just saying, I look at it this way. You have a movie who employs a lot of people, and it costs a lot of money to make a movie, and we all enjoy going to movies.
They've already paid, though. It's not like they're waiting for the money from the movie to
get sold. No, that... Well, it works like this. You make a movie, you make money. That allows you to make another movie, and so on and so forth. For every movie we see, it makes lots of money. That allows them to take that money and make the next big movie. That's how Disney's doing. They all do it that way.
But those theater companies are making a lot of money. It's not like they're worrying about the ticket sales to be a certain amount.
This is the lowest summer for ticket sales.
Because the movies have been that good.
The movies, I think, have been very good this year. Compared to, I think last year was horrible. Last year was dog shit.
This year's been really good, though, on like superhero movies.
That's the other problem. We can't just be dependent on superhero movies.
Well, those are the only ones that sell tickets.
I disagree, though, because there's a lot of
What other movies sell tickets this year besides Dunkirk? Which is made by a guy who made superhero movies.
But it wasn't a superhero movie.
No, but he was a guy who used to make a superhero movie, so that's why people went to see it.
He made three, but...
But they were probably the best superhero movies ever made.
But
so
that's,
people went because of that name.
But that makes no
sense. People didn't go to Dunkirk to see Harry Styles. People went to Dunkirk because Christopher Nolan made it.
Yes, because he's a great director.
Exactly.
But it has nothing to do with Batman.
I know. I'm saying that's like...
But that's what you're saying.
No, I'm saying as an example.
But you're saying
other people might have thought that, but other people might have said
no. It's a war epic. You're like
other movies, yes.
And if you're a fan of Christopher Nolan,
so besides Dunkirk and the superhero movies, what other movies came out that were like, oh my gosh, you had to go see them in the theater?
I didn't see a lot of. I mean, I know what was that? The comedy there.
Exactly.
Sick.
You can't even.
Sick
name
Love
it.
That did very well for an independent film.
Yeah, that's an independent film.
Yeah, but still, it did pretty good.
But I mean, I'm saying, but so you've named one movie.
Well, you're putting me on the spot, Marc. I'm
well, don't
sure
come up with an argument if you don't have the basis for your argument.
I wasn't coming up with an argument. I'm saying superhero movies shouldn't be all for the theater. That's all I'm saying. And there's a lot of great films
that
come out.
That make better movies. That's all I'm saying.
That's not a good argument because...
Why is it not a good argument?
Because you don't know if it's a good movie until you see it.
If they made better movies besides superhero movies,
yeah,
they wouldn't have to worry about the movies not being that good, about people not going to the movies. And people won't go to the movies. The other reason why people don't go to movies, in my opinion, is because the ticket prices are too high.
Well, of course.
And the concession prices are too high.
Yeah.
And it's kind of not the funnest thing to go to anymore. It's like I'm going to go sit in a huge room with other people... Who might
you
make
like
noise.
You like going.
No,
to
I like going, but I'm saying other people might be like this. They don't like people making noise. People don't like certain things going on. Like, and they just want to wait until they can see it in their own house. Their TV is exactly the same size as a movie screen.
Yeah.
Some places.
Well, I think there's two. It's a twofold situation.
You don't have to pay. You can wait the 4 months because movies are going to come out in 4 months.
We like going to the movies.
We like seeing it when it happens.
But also, I think it's fun seeing it with a bunch of people who enjoy that movie as well.
I've also had this conversation with Claire and with Matt Ryan and some other people. Now, if I didn't have the show, would I go see all those movies right away? Or would I wait?
No, you'd see them right away.
No, I'm just saying. But if we didn't have the show, there's some of them we would wait for.
Oh, yeah. Well, I generally don't go to ones I don't want to see anyway.
Yeah. But I'm saying there's like... So, I mean, if we didn't have the show, I probably wouldn't be as apt to like get out to see certain movies.
Fair enough. But the movies, I don't even know where we came from for this. All I'm saying...
Well, you were saying how the prices of the movies...
I think it's a fair price for seeing something that's so expensively made.
This outlandish idea that this movie pass thing is going to ruin the movie industry.
I said AMC.
That's what I'm saying.
The president of AMC, his fear is that... If this became very popular, like Netflix did, Netflix changed the landscape of movies, okay?
To me, it just sounds like AMC's mad they didn't come up with the idea.
No, actually,
And they don't get a cut.
Believe it or not, AMC... No, they get a cut. They are making their money. They're not losing any money in this.
Off the actual product itself.
No, it doesn't... They're getting paid.
If this was the idea, like if they took movietickets.com, which they all bought into, all the movie theaters bought into.
Yeah, you can buy your movie tickets online.
Movietickets.com, yeah. If they had done that and they decided, okay, with movietickets.com, we're going to release a $10 a month like super plan or something where you can go and see as many movies as you want.
Yeah.
I don't think they'd be complaining as much. That's all I'm saying.
Well, I believe there's probably some truth in that. Yeah, I would agree with
that. It's a little crying over spilt milk kind of thing. It's like
I'm just saying... AMC
is going to ruin all of us.
AMC is not losing money.
I don't think everyone's going to go out and buy a movie pass.
A lot of people will.
For $10 a month and go see more movies than they would usually.
So here's the thing. Movie pass, when they announced it, it jumped. They sold a lot.
Well, of course.
And I think if it becomes the norm, if younger people get this... And it becomes popular.
The fact that you think younger people don't just rip the movies off online and watch them at home instead of going to
people still go to the movies.
I don't think they go to the movies as much as you think they do.
Have you looked at a sale?
You were just saying how the movies are down.
Yeah, this summer the movie sales are down.
So people aren't going to the movies.
People are still going to the movies, though.
No, I'm saying, but not as they would usually.
Probably.
If the thing's down.
If you have Transformers, least, you have these big franchises that didn't do as well, and I think it's because of franchise fatigue.
And the movies were bad.
That's subjective. I don't use that as an argument, if the movie's bad or good, because it's subjective.
But still, if the movie's bad and there's people come out of it...
No.
And the word of mouth on that movie is it's not good after you know people
I
that
think
you think are relatively good at picking movies, then you would say, okay, I'm not going to go see that. I'll wait until it comes out on whatever and then watch it.
Well, I mean, there's another piece of this puzzle. Like
if you said it,
Rotten Tomatoes has really changed the landscape of movie going. A lot of young people.
To the point now where it's on your television screen.
Yeah. Younger people will see that rating, and that will definitely change people's minds to see it or not. And some average movies that are really good sometimes won't make as much money because people are like, I'm only going to go see if it has a 98 fresh rating. And sometimes...
But I can also tell you there's a group of people, a group of kids out there who don't even go to the movie theater that just rip it offline and watch it.
Yes, we know that.
So I'm saying there's like...
I mean, that's not part of the conversation here, though. I'm not talking about
that.
Well,
it is because that's also the reasoning why people aren't going and they're losing money on movies.
Yeah, I mean, listen... Ticket sales are down this year because there was probably just – you had from what they said about ticket sales being down, you have Fast and Furious and Transformers, two big franchises.
And Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yes, and Pirates. They didn't do as well as expected because I think it's franchise fatigue. Nobody cares about those franchises anymore. They're waning.
The movies weren't there.
There's only so many you can make of these things.
I think you have to count into it that the movies weren't as good as the other ones were.
I don't know. I'm sure something. I don't know. I didn't see them. They're not my
producing
taste.
Producing a movie, like, I'm not into the Transformers thing anymore after the first two.
You used
two,
to. You've seen them all.
Two. No, I only saw, like, the first two.
You've seen them all.
No, I haven't. I haven't even seen the Mark Wahlberg one. I've never seen any of the ones Mark Wahlberg.
All right.
So, I think this day and age, it was something that it worked in the original Transformers cartoon movie, but I don't think it would work in this movie. I didn't think it was going to work. That they showed in the trailer that Optimus Prime was the bad guy in this movie.
Yeah.
Or that was the shtick. That he was.
It's literally Fast and Furious.
Yeah. So it's just like...
Vin Diesel's the bad guy.
Yeah. And that's... People don't want that.
It's the same movie. Yeah.
I think that's what hurt those two movies, is that people maybe. Like...
Yeah, when you make...
Why is this guy in certain movies been good, and all of a sudden in this movie you're going to flip the switch and now he's a bad guy?
Yeah, it could be it. It's like Hulk Hogan turned bad. Did people really like that? I didn't.
At the beginning, they didn't. But after a while, it kind of just... People just went with it.
Well, because you're stuck with it.
Well, not that you're stuck with it. It's just...
You're stuck with it.
He was really good as a bad guy.
So, I'm just saying... I don't even know...
And then Pirates, I didn't even know it even came out.
Yeah, I could give two shits about Pirates anymore. I thought the last one was horrible, bad. So I'm just saying, you know, MoviePass is a good deal. It's definitely a good deal. I don't know how long they're going to make it.
And the data mining thing, I think, might be the downfall.
I don't think people care.
No, but I mean, if people, I'm just saying, it might be the thing that.
I honestly don't think we care, but people don't care. Like we sit here and we go on Facebook and we bitch and moan about, like, how dare the internet have all my information on Facebook that has all my information.
I just put all my information on this Facebook page.
And when you sign those little boxes, when you click it and it says yes.
Yeah, we allow me in to look at your photos and everything and your phone.
Everybody has all your information. Sorry.
Yeah.
Hate to blow it to you.
Hate to pull the...
You go on Amazon, you search for an item, and the rest of the day, any webpage you search, there's the items in the corner.
I got started doing the Smuggler's Bounty thing for Funko.
Yeah.
And like now, like for the past like 6 months, the little ads on everything is about Smuggler's Bounty.
Yes, because the cookies...
It's like,
Been spread.
I already bought it. You don't have to keep trying to sell it to me.
But that's...
You search for a lawnmower. You search the Home Depot website. You're looking at Home Depot ads for the next, like, month.
Yep. Basically. That's how it works now.
Yeah. It's ridiculous.
And now the cable companies will be allowed to share information because the...
Net neutrality.
There was another thing signed... The administration signed something that allows all the cable companies to share our information without our consent.
Yeah, that's great.
A lot of them saying they're not, but we don't know.
Well,
they want to keep good faith, but they could be saying it. AT&T did it. They said it and
AT&T's
shared.
AT&T's not a cable company.
I know, but they did it to cell phones.
They're a phone company.
They still did it.
Yeah. Well, AT&T's a bunch of...
So-and-sos.
as the kids would say.
Anyway, I'm not trying to argue with any. I'm just telling you from what I read and what I'm just saying, the movie pass is a great deal. But the question would be, and I think the president of AMC makes a good question, would this change the landscape come 10 years if this became a very popular thing?
Of course it will.
And I don't know
if... So did Netflix, so did Redbox, so did anything.
But that would... If but I don't that think, became a thing, that would be rough. I also think
Netflix was the total reason why Blockbuster went out of business.
Yes, it was, because Blockbuster didn't compete. They had an opportunity to sit here and say, we can do the same thing, but they chose not to.
Well, I'm just saying, yeah. I mean, they could have done a lot. There was also a lot of things kind of against Blockbuster and like Hollywood Video and all those places besides that. There wasn't the convenience factor. Sunk it. And the Redbox thing is what really sunk it.
Well, I will go back with you on that. Netflix didn't start off as streaming, though.
You had to send the thing and they sent you a movie.
Yeah, so the convenience...
Like Gamefly, kind of.
Yeah, but the convenience was actually Blockbuster. I could go to Blockbuster and bring it home.
At that time, that's what I was all about. I was still going to Blockbuster at that time.
Yeah.
Netflix was sending you
But the then movies. The convenience was having it mailed to you.
Yeah.
You just get it at home.
But I have to wait. That was the thing. Whereas I went to Blockbuster, it was in my hand right away.
And then they started streaming, and then it changed. That's what I'm saying, though.
Now, if movie theaters did that, or that was a thing that came up, whereas you can get a movie instantaneously on your home TV.
They talk about that, but you're talking $50 or $60 for a movie.
Yeah. That's when it's going to be the problem.
Yet again, I'd rather go pay $13, go to the theater.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, I put value on a movie that I want to support by paying $13.
Some movies, just experience of being in the movie theater is what the whole point of it is.
Yeah.
I mean, the big blockbusters, that's what you're there for.
Yeah.
Like, you know, a random romantic comedy, I'm not really as apt to like run to the movie theater to see it.
Yeah.
I wait until it's on my TV screen because I don't really need the whiz-bang part of the movie theater.
The whiz-bang?
Yeah,
but I say you know, concession is where these movie theaters are making their money. They make their money off concession, big time. Yeah. They don't really, you know, they're not making a big profit off the movie. They're making money off concession.
For $10 or for $1 more, you can get a large one.
You always get the large one anyway.
Well, yeah. Well, I don't give you that. I get the little. I got the cup in the bucket.
The bucket? It sounds so good when you say the bucket. I got the bucket in the trough.
What do you call it? Popcorn bucket. The popcorn.
Yeah, the popcorn bag, whatever.
Yeah. Bucket. I got like the one that they give you that you can buy at the beginning, end of the year for the next year. You get like for $3.50, you get a cup and you buy like for $7. You buy the cup and the popcorn.
I don't know what you're talking
about. No, you don't. Like,
I don't know.
Like, go to the movies. I always have with me the plastic cup.
Uh-huh.
And the plastic popcorn bucket.
You bring it back?
Yeah. At the end of the year, I found out like 2 years ago, I found out about this. You go at the end of the year, they start selling it for the next year.
Uh-huh.
For $3.50, you get a cup. And for $3.50, you get the popcorn bucket.
And you bring it.
Then you bring it, and you spend like the $7 or whatever. And you then every time you go,
mm-hmm.
instead of spending the prices that are on the thing, you fill up your cup for $3.50 and your popcorn for $3.50. And you get, you know, pay like $7 as opposed to paying $15,
$20. Wow.
It's a large, like, soda and, like, a medium popcorn.
Wow.
Yeah.
I've never seen you with this.
Yeah. I bring it every time we go.
All right. Next movie. I'm gonna be watching.
I'll have it at Thor. I bring it with me everywhere.
All right. But anyway, that's MoviePass.
The only way I didn't bring it to, I didn't have the bucket because I was in the middle of the move, so I didn't, when we went to Guardians of the Galaxy. And they had the cool Guardians of the Galaxy bucket.
You and your buckets. You bring them to the beach, make sandcastles.
Yep. That's what I do.
Oh,
you know me, sitting on the beach.
Making sandcastles.
Making sandcastles.
With your buckets.
With all my different popcorn buckets.
The sand comes out easily when there's butter still in there.
Yeah, that's what helps.
Yeah.
It helps with the transition of the...
It coagulates the sand to form into a great wall of China.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's why I built my own wall.
Yes.
I don't need Mexico's money.
Yeah.
Greatest memes ever last night. That's all I got to say.
Oh, yeah. I've seen one. Yeah. I saw one. All right.
We're going to make the
Ugh. We can make the Weight Walkers
pay for it. Weight Walkers pay for this wall.
Force Friday. Is this Friday, Mark?
This Friday. Force Friday 2.
Look at that. Look at that.
Target's doing, only one in this area, if you're in the Enfield area where we're doing the show from.
Yeah.
The only one doing the Force Friday for Target is Enfield.
Yeah.
I looked it up last night as you were texting about it. There's no other place around here. Holyoke's not doing it. Manchester's not doing it. I think the next closest one's like Torrington.
Yep. What about Toys R Us? You're going to
Toys R Us. Every Toys R Us is doing it.
Yeah.
It's like on their website, all Toys R Us's.
Mm.
You don't have to worry about like looking. So,
wow.
If you go to Toys R Us, they're doing a thing where you purchase, you get a free T-shirt and a free poster.
Yeah, Target's going to be giving away giant plushies.
Go and get like one or two like things maybe.
Oh, I'm going.
Yeah,
the list is online. I sent you the link.
Yeah, I know. I saw.
Yeah, I just want to get the new figures and anything Princess Leia.
There's a couple cool dual packs that I want to get. Like there's a Han Solo Boba Fett one.
Yeah.
They're going to put out.
Yep.
I'll probably snag that one.
So this is Thursday night.
The website that you sent me wasn't very great because every time I would look at it, it went to some ad.
I know. See, yet again, ads.
Yeah. It'd bog down and be like, here's like four ads for.
Yeah, I don't know.
Nothing. It's like, I don't really want to look at any of this. But no, here, I got it right here. So they're going to have your figures are Rey, Jedi Training, Poe Dameron, Resistance Pilot, Kylo Ren, Finn, Resistance Fighter, First Order Stormtrooper, Luke Skywalker, General Hux, Rose Tico, which is one of the new characters, Resistance Tech, Paige Tico, which is a Resistance Gunner, Chewbacca with Porg, which is one of the new creatures that they're going to introduce, C-3PO, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Yoda, Emperor Palpatine, Princess Leia Organa from Hoth.
Mm.
So that's going to be like the early ones, probably. Deluxe 2-packs, Rey and an elite Praetorian Guard. Han Solo and Boba Fett, Darth Maul and Qui-Gon Jinn.
Yeah, they're bringing back some old episode ones.
Deluxe fighter sets, a Rath Tar and Bala Tick. Probe Droid and Darth Vader, Wampa and Luke Skywalker from Hoth. That one's going to be kind of cool.
Mm.
Then the vehicles are Resistance A-Wing with Resistance Pilot Tally, Canto Bite Police Speeder with Police Officer, Resistance Sky Speeder with Police Officer, Sky Speeder with Captain Poe Dameron, and then Kylo Ren's TIE Silencer and Kylo Ren, the pilot of that. They're going to have a Force Link Starter Kit, a BB-8 Mega Star Destroyer with Supreme Leader Snoke and Elite Praetorian Guard. And then the 6-inch figures. You're going to have a Hera, a Rey, a Luke Skywalker, an Admiral Thrawn, which is going to be awesome. That's from either Rebels or if he's in this movie, that's going to be epic.
Mm.
Kylo Ren, Darth Vader, a reissue, Stormtrooper reissues, AT-AT Driver reissue, a Poe Dameron, a Finn, a General Leia, a Chewbacca, Elite Praetorian Guard, Centerpiece Assortment, Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader. And then exclusive 6-inch scale figures are a Tango Black, which is only at Target, a Clone Commander Kree, which is only at Toys R Us, a Supreme Leader Snoke with Throne at GameStop, and Elite Guards 4-pack, which is also at GameStop. And then more 6-inch scale vehicles, Rey Speeder with Rey, and an X-34 Land Speeder with Luke Skywalker. And then they have a Titanium Series helmets. They're going to have the Victor Guard and Tango Red. Those are the ones where it's just the helmets, those new things. You've seen those?
Mm-hmm.
I saw them at Walgreens. And then they have a Roleplay helmet where you can get a Pro Dameron helmet and Rey Jedi Training Force Effects lightsaber. So they have like that'll be one of the new things. Then I'm assuming there's going to be like Lego stuff too that they haven't. And Funko stuff, which they haven't released it as exactly what it is.
Yeah.
That's all the Hasbro stuff.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm excited for the. I'm definitely going to be going this Thursday night.
Mm.
So you're going to go to the HasCon?
I was going to go to HasCon. I planned on going. I planned on getting tickets and everything.
$60, baby.
But I'm not going. I can't go.
Why?
Matt Ryan is doing the show at the Eastfield Mall.
I thought that was two different weekends, though.
No, it's the same weekend as HasCon. HasCon's that second weekend.
Oh.
And also that same weekend is Camp Anime for Matt's Sports Cards and Collectibles.
You're going to Camp Anime, too?
No, Matt is. Matt's going to go... Because he's doing a, seminar, his comic construction thing or whatever.
Yeah.
At Camp Anime. So that's Saturday. I'm meeting up with him in the morning at the Eastfield Mall. And he's going to stay with me until he has to go to Woodstock, Putnam area for his thing. And then he's coming back because that show goes from like, the show at Eastfield Mall goes on Saturday, goes from like 10 a.m. to 9 p.m.
Mm.
All day.
Yeah.
So he's going to come back and finish that. And then I'm also going to work his booth for him Sunday because he has Simsbury Days or whatever it is, like Long Meadow Days kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's their like summer fest or whatever for like end of summer thing where they hired him like last week to do caricatures and he double booked himself and didn't realize it. So he asked me to cover for him at his booth on Sunday.
Wow.
So I'm going to work his booth for him on Sunday. And
cool.
So... Yeah, so I'll be there.
Busy.
Yeah.
That's two weekends from now.
This weekend I'll be at the Woodstock Fair all weekend.
The Woodstock Fair.
For kart racing.
Kart racing.
Yeah, at the Woodstock Fair. It's a good fair. It's a nice fair.
Yeah.
Wilson Phillips is going to be there.
Ooh.
Yeah, on Saturday.
Wilson Phillips.
Yeah.
Well, color me red and slap my ass.
No, thank you.
What has she done?
It's the group of them. It's a group. Wilson Phillips.
Yeah, what are they saying?
Hold on for one more day. That was in Bridesmaids.
Well, it's before Bridesmaids.
I know, but I'm saying that's the recent thing that people would memorize them for.
I forgot that was in there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I remember. It was at the end. It was a big movie.
Yeah, I know. I remember.
Okay. But yeah, that's about all I know about
Wilson Phillips. Woohoo! It's as big as the deal as a Smash Mouth.
Then I have like
Mouth.
Some big country acts on like Sunday and Monday. They usually do like
They
have big country acts.
Cool.
Or like up and coming country acts or whatever. But,
up
yeah.
and coming.
So
let's talk about Doctor Who.
Yes.
I finished it, Mark. Aren't you proud of me?
I am.
So
it's about damn time.
I have to say.
I just thought of something I was going to ask you too, and I just totally slipped my mind.
Well, I want to say this before you ask me anything.
Okay.
People who complained about the female doctor, clearly you didn't watch this season at all. Those last two episodes, literally, if I didn't know who the new doctor was, they beat you over the head with it. There's many clues, but the biggest clue is you have the original master meeting up with the new master.
Yes.
Then you have Bill and you have the doctor on a park bench talking about life. And she says, so you can regenerate as anybody, even a woman? And he goes, yeah, we don't have genders. We're not stuck on it like you guys are.
Yeah.
And I think I'm like, okay. And then when they say their final goodbyes, when Bill and him, she says, you remember what I told you? And I forget if he said it back to her or she repeated it, but it was basically, I like girls and people my own age.
Yeah.
And he goes, I won't forget that. So he's regenerating as a female because of Bill. He always has a reason why he regenerates to the person he does. And we know Peter Capaldi was a guard in the previous Doctor Who series, and he regenerated as that guard. And there's always a reason why they pick who they do, generally.
Because he respected that guard from Pompeii.
Yes. So now he's playing it forward because Bill is dead.
Yes.
Spoiler alert.
Which is why I didn't want to say anything to you.
It's so sad. It was so good. It was so good. Well, she became
a water creature like the other girl.
Well, she became the Cybermen first.
Yes.
Then she died and got to join her friend from the very beginning of
the first episode,
which was so cool to see that. And, oh, my God, it was good.
Mm.
And I love the master outmastering the master, then outmastering the master, and then he survives. You know, both of them survive somehow. But
no,
you don't think so?
She's not coming back.
She's not coming back. She's dead.
She's gone too.
Because she wasn't the planet. Well, not the ship, I should say. And one of the levels, I believe, was blown up anyway.
Yes. Yeah.
So, and he went down.
Yeah.
What a switcheroo, though. He was pretending to be this old guy, and he lived with Bill for years. Because time had moved faster, and time had moved slower upstairs.
By the black hole.
It was cool. I liked it. This season was by far my favorite Doctor Who season, like...
Which is really strange because it's one of my favorites too, but it's like been like panned by like a lot of people. Like a lot of fans of it didn't like this season.
And I think this season
can't wait for Moffat not to be involved anymore. And
they're bitter. They're bitter.
It's just, I don't know what their problem is, but it's just like
who are you talking to?
No, there's been like a lot of stuff online and like a lot of people talking about it.
Marc, you have to realize more people are apt to complain online than say good things.
Oh, no, I'm just saying that that's been a... I loved it.
I think the season was amazing. You know what? I think it was so good.
It was one of the few seasons of Doctor Who. There's been a couple of them that have like made me like bawl my eyes out. Like, I can't believe what.
Since the Ponds.
Since that.
I'll say it right now. I wasn't a big fan of Claire. Or Clara.
Clara. Yeah.
She wasn't my favorite.
She was a good companion.
But we'll be honest. She's good looking. But beyond that, once Matt Smith left, I didn't like it.
It was a great transition piece to get to Capaldi. You needed that. After how much Matt Smith was loved by the fans and by everybody, and how great he was as a doctor, you needed that bridge person to get you from one.
They're always a bridge person, but...
This is going to be the interesting one, though.
She wasn't my favorite.
This is
going to
be an interesting one. This is going to be the first time, and I think since they came back, the Doctor Who came back, that you're going to go into a new season with a new companion and a new Doctor.
No, I thought Matt Smith came in that way.
No, because there was still Amy Pond was...
No, Amy Pond was always with Matt Smith. He wasn't with Tennant.
But he still had like a connection person. Alex Kingston, his character... River Song was the connection person.
Yeah, but was she really considered a companion?
Well, she was still around. I'm saying there was still that person in the universe that was still a connector person to that. Like, the only person that would be the... What's his face there?
Yeah, but he's now living on a level on that ship with those people.
Yeah.
I guess he could come back. I like him a lot.
Yeah.
It was good, though, man. I really liked it a lot. Big time. Like, the whole season... Also, I think taking that year off to give us really good episodes...
Churning through them like they did before.
They need to do this more often. Take a year off and make... And really hone in on a good season.
Just make a good season. Why do you need a year off to do it? Just make it a better season.
You know what happens? You become...
The problem with Doctor Who becomes a circle. The one thing I will say against... Moffat being the producer of it and being the writer of all the episodes.
He's not writer of all episodes.
No, I'm saying of most of the episodes. The problem was getting to be, because he was also doing this, and he was also working on the Sherlock Holmes show, where those are like three episodes, and they're like big, huge, deep writing episodes, where you really have to like...
Yeah, but Moffat doesn't write all of Doctor Who episodes.
No, but he wrote a majority of them for a while. He was writing the majority of the episodes.
He usually writes like the beginnings and the... He does the main arc.
He was really involved in it.
Of course.
But him and Gaddis were like deep into the Sherlock Holmes stuff.
Yeah.
For doing those three movies. Like, it's basically three movies you're making back to back to back.
Yeah.
In a year's time, basically. So I think that was a thing that people were like, you take too much time because you got this going on. You can't like focus on Doctor Who, and you're not making Doctor Who as good as it could be because you're wasting time on this other thing. You're not wasting time, but it's, you know, you don't have the time to focus on Doctor Who like you did at the time. But I think that was the only thing that I think people, that's what I think was one of the problems with it. But I still say it was like the best, one of the best seasons.
Yeah.
Of Doctor Who since it came back.
Oh, me too. But didn't Sherlock Holmes come out last year?
Yes. Yeah.
See?
Well, they just did the one Christmas special.
But Sherlock Holmes is out. You have a whole year to come up with a great storyline, a story arc.
And there's only
have
three of
the
them.
Side episodes.
That's the thing with
you know?
Sherlock Holmes. There's only three of them. And you only got those three episodes. And it's like, you have to like focus
takes a
on,
lot of work.
It's a little bit different than, yeah.
Well, it takes a lot of work no matter what. Because if you were to break those episodes into half-hour stories, that would be a lot of episodes.
Yeah.
So you just... putting it all together. I mean, it's a movie. It probably takes a couple months to make one of those. Yeah. And Doctor Who
is basically an hour-long movie every week, basically.
Yeah.
For like 12 weeks or whatever it is.
It was good, man. I really liked it. I like how it ended with him on that ice planet there, and then you hear the voice of the original Doctor, and he repeats what Peter Capaldi said, and he's like, he's like, who am I? I'm the Doctor. I'm the original. And then he lands, and then you hear him say it, and it's like, oh my God, it's going to be so good. So excited. I mean.
Christmas special.
Oh, can't wait. So exciting. So exciting. But it's awesome. I'm so happy.
And the Christmas specials are always more, it's even more of like the other ones we've seen with the regeneration and all that's going to make it even more intense.
Of course, yeah. I mean, it's so weird to think that it's...
He's been doing it for 3 years now. This is for third series, right? Wasn't it? Or second?
Not second. I think three or four.
3 or 4 years. That's a long time for a doctor. Yeah. Nowadays.
Yeah.
Like Eccleston, it was one or two.
Yeah, but he was in the beginning. They've brought it back.
Yeah.
He didn't want to stay. He wanted to leave anyway.
No, but still.
He could have stayed longer.
David Tennant was on for a while. He was like 4 or 5.
Yeah, I don't know.
It was a while.
Yeah.
And then Smith was like still so good in the
Good Wife, whatever it's called.
The Crown.
The Good Crown.
Whatever. The Crown Life.
Ewan McGregor.
The Crown
Life. Ewan McGregor.
Fights. He's great. He's great in that.
The Crown.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, you're right. The Crown.
The Crown.
His career has definitely taken off.
Yeah.
And he was in some movies and whatnot.
Yeah, he's been stuff here and there.
But it was so good. Okay, so I watched all Game of Thrones this weekend. So good. It was a good season, man. Everything, I'm not used to everything moving
like,
so fast.
I think this is one of the things I was going to ask you. Because you're doing the other show.
Yeah.
About Twin Peaks.
Yeah.
Is this the next golden age of television, basically? Are we in the next golden age of television?
We've said this, yes.
No, I know. I was saying, like, recently. Are we, like, in, like...
Like, the, we've been the in the time... golden age of television for at least 5 years.
Yeah.
Or more.
I'm saying, like, right now, though, for nerddom, it's, like, the best of times, basically.
I think
Doctor
so.
Doctor Who is, like, kicking ass. Game of Thrones is crazy good.
It's always been good.
And now you have... Twin Peaks is back, and it's like...
Well, it's ending next week.
On par with, like, everything else. It's actually good and not...
It was always good.
Know. But I'm saying, knowing now that you've seen the episodes, you know they're actually good.
Yeah.
A little different than at the beginning of this. You weren't sure what was going to... I mean, you knew you, as a fan of it...
Yeah, you don't know.
You knew it was going to be good. You were hoping it was going to be good, but now you've actually seen them, and you know they're good.
Yeah,
it's so it good. Makes it a little bit easier to be like... Yeah, all right, good, okay. Yeah, we're
going to
be all right.
Well, yeah, you always go into unknown.
It's like, okay, it's going to be all right. Everybody can take a breather.
It's the unknown. You go into the unknown.
Yeah.
I mean, the golden age of television has been around for like 5 years or more.
Yeah.
I think the TV's...
But this weekend alone was
And maybe that's why movie sales are down, because people are binging
stay
things.
Stay at home.
You stay at home and watch The Defenders, or you stay at home
Which
and watch...
Which was also excellent.
You know what's weird?
A bit slow, but excellent.
It's so weird. I'm not compelled yet to watch Defenders. It's weird.
I wasn't either. I kind of just was like, I had a slow weekend last weekend. Like, I didn't have a lot going on.
Yeah. So I know. Like, I'll watch
it. Oh, hey. Defenders came out. I'll take a look at it.
Like,
it's slow. Don't expect to be like Daredevil where you jump right in and there's stuff going on.
No.
It's a slow burn and it's a thinker. You have to pay attention.
The Defenders can't be much of a thinker.
There's a little bit of thinking involved. There's a little bit of a... Unfortunately, you kind of have to know a little bit about Iron Fist, so read a little bit about Iron Fist beforehand.
Yeah, I'll watch the YouTube thing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, watch a recap video or something.
Yeah.
Because you need to know some of the stuff that goes on with... It's a lot of Iron... They really are trying to sell Iron Fist a lot.
Because they know how bad he is?
Yeah. They're really, like, it's like a really, like, hard sell.
Well, let's talk about more about Game of Thrones.
Yes, Game of Thrones.
Okay. So, we found out,
Oh, all right, let's do this.
What?
If you haven't seen the final episode of Game of Thrones yet, if you're like Bryon and you're waiting until, you know...
I already watched it.
A special, like, thing gets thrown up in the air and you get, like, a target practice or something. We'll give you 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All two people turn us off.
We're now into Game of Thrones. We'll talk about that after we get done with this, too. That's in your hand there you're looking at.
All right, let's get to it.
Well, stop looking at things and talk about it. Game of Thrones.
So, the biggest thing I thought...
You're looking at books over there.
The biggest thing I thought...
Yes.
...was we found out that Dany and Jon Snow... Dany's Jon Snow's aunt.
That was the thing I was trying to figure out. Is it his aunt?
Yes.
Or is she his niece? Or how does that work relationship-wise?
No, she is his aunt.
Because her brother? Was that her brother's?
That was her brother.
That was her brother that was getting married to the girl? Okay. Mm-hmm. That's what I was thinking. I was like, it looked like her brother.
You know, here's the best way to figure this out. And I heard it from the
it's
people.
It's been so long.
The people who made the show. If you were to wait till after the credits, they do a behind the look after every episode.
Yeah.
And they literally, because me and Alice were watching going, wait, is who? Wait.
Yeah, exactly.
Literally at the end.
But I was like so exhausted. I'm like,
the producer says, we find out that Dany is Jon Snow's aunt. And we're like, oh, man.
So no matter what, it's a creepy situation.
It's Luke and Leia all over again.
All over again. It's basically they ripped that from Star Wars.
Oh.
The relationship.
A lot of stuff has been borrowed from Star Wars.
Yeah.
It's interesting though. I think he might be the only one to impregnate her because if they're related, he would have dragon blood in him too. And if she can't get pregnant from a normal person, he would be the only one to do it.
So he's gonna.
I bet you she's gonna get pregnant.
Father and uncle.
Dude, if she's gonna get pregnant.
So he'd be the father of his uncle.
Well, no.
Yeah.
She is the aunt.
Yes.
He is the nephew.
Yeah. But if he gets his aunt pregnant and she has a baby, that'd be his uncle.
No, he would be a dad. He'd just be a dad.
He'd also be the dad.
He would be a dad.
Of his uncle.
And he'd be an uncle.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, you're right.
No, the kid would be his uncle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No! He would be uncle.
Or cousin?
When your aunt.
As a kid, that's your cousin.
As your cousin.
So he'd be the dad of his cousin.
Yes. I don't know. I'm just saying yes.
Why in Game of Thrones you have to be so incestuous?
But they don't know. But they don't know.
I know, but it's so weird.
Well.
And why is Bran just coming up to this now?
No, well, he's been gone.
He sees all, knows all.
Yeah, but he's been gone.
But why didn't I think of this earlier?
No, he goes, we need to tell him. And then
he's sending ravens all over the goddamn place. He couldn't have sent a raven and be like, hey, by the way, your what's-her-face's
Sam,
nephew.
No, but Sam is the one that says, I read this in the secret diary. So Bran goes, oh, shit. Well, and then Sam's like, I don't know why he would lie. So Bran didn't have the full thing until he talked to Sam. And Sam said, in this diary,
that's true.
He read about the wedding.
That's true.
There was a secret wedding.
I know. They showed it.
Yeah. So.
I agree.
It would make no sense.
I gotcha.
See what I'm saying?
Just that kid sends a lot of ravens. Just because he's a three-eyed raven. Sends a lot of ravens.
Dude, that dragon, man.
And the time thing. Like, I've talked to a couple people who said the time thing is throwing people off. That they don't like the time.
Because it's only 7 episodes. Thing. They have to ramp
it up. I know, but it's like...
What? I like it. I like how fast it moves.
The fact that, like, her dragon is, like, can go warp speed, basically, from the south all the way up to beyond the wall in a matter of minutes.
It wasn't a matter of minutes. It was
but
a day.
But the raven, like,
it was a day and a half.
The raven flew to them, and then that raven then found this person, and the raven magically went to there. And then the raven flies fast enough to get all the way to Winterfell and all the way down to Dragonstone. And then from Dragonstone, a dragon flying from Dragonstone to beyond the wall is quicker than a guy running from from Out Beyond the Wall to the wall, then sending a writing a thing, attaching it to a raven, having the raven fly all the way to, you know what I mean? That's just a little bit of movie time mix up that
they have to move the things quickly.
Oh, I know they have to, but yeah. I'm just saying just kind of
here.
I've heard some people say that's an issue.
To me, I perceived it as them being in that little island for almost 2 days because when what's his name takes off, it was daylight. As he approaches the wall, it's getting dark. He gets there.
Can you say this whole thing is the Hound's problem? The Hound's one that caused all this.
Well, he's antagonizing with the rocks.
Yeah.
Yes. But then the raven goes. Then it was daytime. They showed him sleeping.
I know.
So it was like 2 days. Yeah, it was 2 days at least. Yeah. So I don't think, the time didn't really. I will only nitpick one thing.
The other thing I.
No, let me nitpick. Let me throw my nitpick out there. The only thing I thought was funny, and you have to take it as a grain of salt, was how did all the White Walkers come up with that gigantic chain, wrap it around a dragon underwater, and pull it up?
Yeah.
I was like, that chain was literally wrapped around its neck and its arms, and it's this huge ass chain. Where'd they get this chain from? That's my biggest gripe, but I have to just enjoy it. And just that's cool looking. I can't complain. It's cool. Yeah. But where did they come up with the chain? Did they have the chain? Were they making a chain?
It was around one of the giants that you only see on wide shots, but you don't see them when they're actually walking. What? Or that scene where they're all surrounding them on that little piece of rock. There's none of the giants are there. It's just the humans.
I think the giants aren't being used right now. They're using them for major war.
Saying, but
have the two giants.
I know, but the whole horde was surrounding them.
Correct.
On the little rock.
Yep.
And in all the shots, none of them saw the giants. There's no shots of the giants.
I didn't see the giants at all.
Exactly. But then, two episodes later, when they're walking through the wall, the giants are magically back again.
Actually, we saw the giants at the beginning of season 2.
And the beginning of the season, when they do the wide shot of the ravens flying over the whole
thing. They're using
those. You see one.
Those giants are going to be used for
the battle. It's just kind of like, what, the giants took the day off?
They
weren't there that day?
The giants are. You keep the giants.
Because I'm saying, because that would have been the part where I would have thought they would have had the scene where John's looking across all the giants. Or all the humans, and sees one as one of the dead.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
And that would have been that scene of him being like, they've even taken my friends and turned them into, the dead.
Mm. Yeah. They lost a lot of good people during that scene. I mean, you lost the guy who could bring the other guy back to life.
Yeah. Well, he's
dead.
Stuff anyway, so. But.
The zombie polar bear was awesome.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Yeah.
I mean, the special effects were freaking amazing. Mm. The fact that they got a dragon to come back was just like, what? When it ended, like, no.
Well, and what I showed at the beginning of the season, I showed you that still they had the poster that they had this year was the White Walker on the dragon.
And now we got to see it.
On top of the wall.
Yeah.
And I showed it to everybody, and they're like, oh, no, that's not real. That's not what's going to happen. That's exactly what happened. They wouldn't put it in the poster if it wasn't something they wanted you to look forward to. Walker on a dragon.
It was awesome.
Coolest thing ever invented.
Knocked down that wall. The wall came down. Didn't you want to hear, and the walls come tumbling down.
And the walls come tumbling down. You know, someone's sitting at home right now in their parents' basement doing that, like, lining up that song with the video.
Probably.
It'll be on YouTube within an hour or two.
It was good, man. I can't believe we have to wait. The biggest one was Littlefinger getting it. Thank God.
I've never heard Claire scream so loud and be so excited for something in my life.
Oh, we were both excited. We were so happy.
If it ever happened, I'm like, if I ever proposed to you or anything like that happens down the road, you wouldn't be that excited for that. You're more excited for this. It was amazing to see her. Like, she like flipped. She jumped out of her chair.
Well,
stood up and then jumped backwards and fell back into the couch again. Like jumping and flailing her legs in the air. Like that much excitement for watching this guy get his neck slit.
I only believe...
I'm waiting for this since the beginning of the show.
Well, he sucks, but also...
He's awful. He's a terrible person.
I didn't like this whole Arya versus...
Sansa.
I'm like, this makes no sense.
It didn't.
Arya, all of a sudden, is a bitch. Like, you're like, what? Like, she's just like, fuck you. I'm going to kill you. Like,
well, there's been that...
They didn't have animosity like that.
There's been that weird theory that it's not really Arya.
It is Arya.
No, I'm saying, but there's been that theory thrown out there that she died in the fight with the no one.
Yeah, I know. But
now it's like it's her.
It's really her. It was so satisfying when she walks up and then Sansa says, "Yeah, you know, blah blah blah," and turns to Littlefinger and we're like. And he's just like, excuse me? And it's good.
Are you talking to me? I didn't know what you're talking about. And take it back to the veil. Take it back to the veil.
To see him grovel and like beg for mercy was really good. Like it was so satisfying, his death. Yeah. It was so good to see a death to a bad, someone everybody hates.
Yes.
Because I was like, okay, who's going to die that we like? You know, who? And I can't believe Cersei didn't Cersei didn't kill either of her brothers, which I was just like, Jamie's gonna get it.
Oh, I know, in the mountain. Claire was like, don't you dare have the mountain do that. And the part where the hound walked up to the mountain.
Yeah.
Ugh.
He's gotta kill the mountain.
He has, the only person that can.
Yeah. He said, brother.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get ya.
I know what they did to you. But that was also a cool scene too, where all those people that haven't been together.
All the main characters all in one place.
Meeting together again for like the first time.
It was pretty awesome. Pretty epic.
Yeah.
Pretty epic. And then Cersei fucking...
backing out and saying she's going to just...
Backing out, having the Greyjoy guy, all of a sudden he's on a set getting this armada.
Go get his sister back and...
Man, it was good. Good. Yeah. I can't believe now we got to wait till next year.
That's going to be the tipping point in that whole thing is he's going to get his sister, not knowing that his uncle is going to get the Golden Army.
Yeah.
So if he goes with his group and goes after
they're probably going to die.
No.
If they have to fight a Golden Army.
Or if they, because they're on a boat, they're not on, like, they can't really do much on a boat. What can they do with elephants on a boat? So if they sink that Golden Army supposedly inside the boats. I'm just saying. But if like any of those guys get lost, then Cersei's like plan of like just holding up in Westeros. But it's gonna be interesting to see how that works. Like, are those generals just gonna like, because Jaime left, they're just gonna be like, oh, okay, because you said so. We actually want Jaime. We actually listen to him.
They don't have a big army. You. Yet again, Cersei's putting her in a position of hiding herself.
Yeah.
Like she has.
I don't think she's really pregnant either. I think she's just saying that.
No, she's pregnant. Because she didn't give two shits about Jaime anymore. They had sex. Then she didn't drink the wine when What's-His-Face put it on her table. Yeah. And then I think all she wanted from Jaime was...
Another heir.
Yes, that's it. Because the moment he came in, he came back, and she's like, she tries to kiss him, and he pulls away. And then all of a sudden, she magically gives him a magic blowjob. Mm. And then they're in bed all of a sudden. He's like, I don't know what to do. She gave me a magic blowjob, and now I'm on her side again. And then
it all happens.
And then...
blowjobs do that to a guy.
Yeah. So it wiped his brain.
It can pretty much wipe your brain of anything. If you're really trapped with a villain in any kind of scenario, I'm pretty sure if there was any... anyone wrote a real superhero story?
If Batman just blew the Joker.
No, if Catwoman blew Batman, I'm pretty sure Batman wouldn't be as apt to throw her in jail right afterwards.
Yeah, it's all sexual tension between the two.
Yeah.
So, yes, I believe she is pregnant, and I believe she's going to do everything to make sure this child's born.
Yeah.
And she needs to. This is it. If she knows if she dies, this is the end. And Jaime... she doesn't believe her brothers are going to go any further.
No, he's going to Winterfell or Dragonstone or whatever.
Because he's smart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got to think that he's going to gather up a part of their army of some sort.
But the thing is, none of
them... He's not just writing by himself to Winterfell. He's not, like, he knows by himself he's not going to be able to do much.
Yeah, but none of them know about the dragon.
Idiots.
They all don't know about the wall falling. I mean, this is big.
They don't know about the wall falling, but they know...
They don't know about the dragon?
Cersei kind of thought of, like, you could see she was trying to put one and one together. She was pretty close. Like, oh, you said she had three dragons, and now there's only two of them. Where's the other one?
Well, he goes, well, it could be hiding. It
Why
could be,
would she do that? There's it no, could something be, else has happened.
It could,
she goes, if the dragons are vulnerable, then they can't even stop.
But it's
the White Walkers.
The dragon is not vulnerable. It's part of the White Walkers. Nobody knows.
No, she's
that.
Saying like the yeah. other two dragons.
It's big, man. It's big. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be. They, what I read is the last six episodes are pretty much going to be a war almost.
It's just all episodes are just, it goes from one to six is just battle.
It was just amazing. It was so good.
Yeah.
It is really good. That show is one of the best.
Yeah.
So far, I put Game of Thrones with me right up there with Breaking Bad because I don't, there's nothing, there's never a bad episode. I haven't come across a bad episode at all. It's really always moving, telling a good story.
And the battle scenes this year have been epic.
Oh, so good. The battle with the Greyjoys was the uncle.
Yeah,
the
boats.
It was filmed very on par with Fury Road.
Yeah.
Mad Max.
Yeah.
The way that they had the frame rate turned up, so everybody moved like this jerky motion, like really fast. It was really cool. Mm. I thought it was a great... I was like, oh my God. It's a very...
The Casterly Rock battle, which was pretty crazy and intense.
The Casterly Rock, they showed up and then it fast forward to him with the woman upstairs in the castle.
No, well, then they're like trying to like... Then they're just walking away.
Oh, well, they had the money. They had the money.
Supplies and everything.
Yes, yes. That was
like
cool.
Like that battle I'm talking about. Oh. That was pretty crazy.
With the dragon just showing up out of the blue.
Yeah.
Yeah, they weren't prepared for that.
They weren't ready for that one.
In the... whatchamacallits.
Yeah.
The guys with the beards.
Dothraki.
The Dothrakians.
Yes.
That was pretty cool.
The Unsullied.
They fucking took care of business.
Yeah.
I thought Jaime was going to die with that dragon when he starts charging.
Yeah. And then Ron tackles him and saves him.
Yeah, that was pretty epic. Mm. I was like, oh my God, is the dragon going to kill him?
And Tyrion just being like, don't, you idiot. Don't do it. Don't, you idiot. Stop.
I know. What do you
realize what you're fighting.
So frigging good.
There's so many scenes that were just, like...
Amazing.
So many epic things.
I know. So we're all caught up, Mark. I'm all caught up.
You're all caught up.
All caught. See? It's good stuff.
I'm excited for you.
I'm excited for myself. And now I gotta watch season two of Ash vs. Evil Dead. That's next.
I didn't even watch... I think I got, like, I don't know, after the end of the first season, I stopped watching.
Oh, I don't have Stars anymore, so... Mm-hmm. I love the first season, so I'm very excited.
Well, I know. I just kind of think I was kind of like, I'm burned out.
It was on sale digitally. I bought the whole season two for $8. So that's my new thing. I'm starting to buy stuff, movies and stuff digitally.
The other one I got to watch is Brockmire. You'll enjoy it.
I don't know what that is.
Hank Azaria.
Oh. Is that on Netflix?
IFC.
Oh, I don't have IFC.
Yeah, but I think it'll probably be on Netflix soon. But... If you get a chance,
let's check it out.
Good one to watch.
Oh, check it out.
I think Azaria's just awesome.
I got to catch up on all my Netflix stuff because Netflix still has the newest season of Wet Hot American Summer. I got to watch that.
Yeah.
Might do that next, actually. I've been dying to watch that.
Paul Rudd replaces Bradley Cooper.
Hmm?
Paul Rudd replaces Bradley Cooper.
No.
Bradley Cooper didn't do this.
No, Adam...
Adam Scott.
Adam Scott replaces Bradley Cooper.
Bradley Cooper, that's right.
And he says, I just got a nose job...
Yeah.
And that's what changed my looks.
Yeah.
And nobody can recognize. He goes, I'm surprised anybody can recognize me. I got a nose job. And everybody, I guess the joke is everybody goes, yeah, we recognize you.
Yeah.
But he thinks nobody's going to recognize him. That stinks at Bradley Cooper because he's filming. He was doing other things. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I think it's kind of funny. I'll have to, I got to watch that still. So. All right, Marcus.
The thing is, what was he filming though? Was he doing Guardians at the time?
Guardians, and I know there's a couple movies he's coming out with him in it, so I don't know. Anything else, Marcus? You and Matt did a new
Free lunch news show. We talked about I found the books that you're looking at right now, Brian. I found those at Barnes and Noble. They were at the cash register. They're giving away for free. That's a catalog of all the new DC graphic, like the novel versions they're doing, like mm-hmm. The full collections.
Mm-hmm.
The other one, the smaller one, is the new previews to all the comics that are curated by Jared Way for My Chemical Romance.
Which one?
The one that you just had in your hand right there.
This one?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, those are all those books that he's a part of.
Yep.
And then the other one.
The Umbrella Club or whatever it's called.
Yeah, well, it's the newer ones he's done since that he stopped doing that one. So it's all the newer books that he's working on.
That's cool.
For DC. And then the last one is a compendium of previews of books from Insight Comics, which is a smaller company, independent company, and they got some cool books that they have out.
Cool.
So they just had them for free at Barnes & Noble, so it was kind of cool.
Nice.
Yeah, but we talked about a bunch of stuff. Matt gave us his adventures at Trificon and all sorts of different things. So yeah, check that out. That's out there. A new Twin Peaks Unwrapped is out today.
Today?
Yeah.
We got a new one coming out today.
Yeah. With some special guests you guys interviewed.
Yeah, today is the 25th anniversary of Fire Walk With Me, and we have John Thorne and one of the writers of Fire Walk With Me. I think it's Bob Angles. Ben got in here on Friday to do the interview.
Yeah.
Which was funny because you texted me.
Well, because he said he was coming for noon.
Yeah.
He said he'd be here at noon. He ended up not getting here until like 12:30.
Yeah.
Because he got stuck at work. So I was like, oh, I rushed all the way here thinking you'd like be waiting for me.
You said you'd be here on time.
I was.
But so
I was
how'd just, you like, rush here?
Well, because I like rushed because I like was a couple minutes. I wasn't exactly at noon.
Uh-huh. Like I knew it. I
it was
knew
like
12:05
when I got here.
This is you. I'll be here at 11. I'm here at 11, Brian. I'm always on time, Brian.
I said I'd be here for noon. I didn't say I'd be here for 11.
You said you're here at 11:30 on Fridays.
Well, usually, but...
Uh-huh.
We got an escaping dog over the...
You and this dog! What is everything's with you and the dog?
Well, because Claire has to go to work in the morning, so I have to take care of the dog in the morning.
You sound like a very bad dog owner. The dog escaping, it's pooping,
well,
it's
on,
eating your homework.
On Friday, he actually escaped on Claire. He ended up two houses down barking at a cat. So on Saturday, Claire's stepdad and her uncle helped, like, went and got a fence, and we put a fence in. So now he can't get out of the yard.
There you go.
So now he's trapped like a rat, and he's not liking it. So that's why he's, like, taking forever now to go outside because he's just, like, bark at the fence for 20 minutes and then it's like just hurry it up, man. It's always you have when you had your dog, you know, it's always when you're in
a
rush.
I take the dog out in the morning.
I do too, but when you're in a rush, it's always when he takes forever to do anything.
So basically you wake up 10 minutes before you have to leave and then you're
all right, hold on a second. I texted you at what time did I text you this morning? 8 o'clock.
Yeah, so why didn't you take the dog out then?
I did. Yeah. And I fed the dog, uh-huh. And then before I leave, uh-huh. Every time to come to work,
because uh-huh.
Claire doesn't come home right away,
uh-huh.
I let him out again so that way he doesn't pee or poop in the house.
Okay. And he's taking his time.
And so yeah, that's when he was taking his time. But then again, someone also texted me at 10:40 or whatever, or 9:40, saying, hey, I could do the show, but I have to do it at like 10:30.
Yes. Because I got.
So I'm like,
I should be leaving
okay,
soon.
So
yeah.
Now I'll, you know, get dressed and I'll let the dog out. Thinking it's weird, it's 11.
Oh, the life of Marc. Life's tough.
It's tough, man.
Hashtag dog problems.
Hashtag real life problems.
Real life problems. All right, Marc, we're out of here.
Yeah. Do it all again next week.
Maybe. Well, we got a holiday Monday.
Oh, that's right. We do have a holiday Monday. We'll probably do it on Tuesday next week then.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, Tuesday.
Yeah, because I'll be at the go-kart. I'll be karting. And it's my birthday next week.
Oh, yeah. What? Tuesday?
Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Thanks for caring, best friend.
I don't know the days and dates.
You don't know the date of my birthday? I know when your birthday is.
I didn't know what day it fell on.
Oh.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
I didn't know if it was Thursday or Wednesday.
All right.
Excuse me.
What number? What number of day?
Is it the 9th?
Nope.
It's the 6th.
Worst best friend ever.
It's the 6th. I have it on my calendar. Is it the 6th?
It is a 6.
It's a 6. I always get that wrong.
Yours is June 21st. It's the first day of summer.
Yeah, yours is Wednesday, yeah.
I know it is. It's my birthday. I know what my birthday is.
I hope you know.
Last I knew when it was.
Something happened.
Something happened?
About the floods.
A lot of... That's crazy down there in Houston.
I know.
It's horrible. Nuts.
It's not good.
But global warming isn't real, so... Don't worry about it, kids.
What's that to do with anything?
That's why there's so much... The floods are so bad, and why the hurricanes are so bad.
Yeah.
Global warming. But they're not. But, you know... Our government seems to think it's not real.
Oh. Why do you always have to talk about Trump?
I don't. I said the government.
You're always bringing up Trump.
The government is not just Trump. There's more people involved in government than just Trump.
I don't know about that, Mark. Have you seen our government?
You should watch another thing cool on Netflix. Bill Nye has his new show on Netflix.
Yeah, I'll watch that.
The science guy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I knew it in season two.
I got through the first episode so far.
Yeah.
It's kind of a... You have to, like, have time to focus on it.
You have to think?
Yeah, it's a thinking show.
Wait, you watched The Defenders, that made you think, and you're okay with it. But when a science guy makes you think, you're like, I just can't do it.
He kind of gets a little much. Bill Nye, science guy.
I loved him as a kid.
I know.
He was great then. I still love him now. I still think he's great.
He's a good guy. He's just a little preachy. He's like a little too much.
Well,
yeah, we get it. You've said it 9 times in this episode.
I think he has to say it because people
beat it into my skull.
People don't listen. You have people who believe the Earth is flat. I mean, how stupid are you?
Dinosaurs never existed.
I mean, if Bill Nye has to come and do a Netflix show and be preachy because
the
these
fact
morons
that
aren't
believe
getting it.
Dinosaurs existed and think it's all just fabricated to make people go to museums as a gimmick. That's amazing.
Who thinks that? I've never heard that before.
Oh, I've heard a couple of people. Couple athletes of.
Well, that's your first problem. Listen to athletes.
No, man, I don't listen. I mean, I just.
Shaquille O'Neal thinks the world is flat.
It. I know. It's so
He's
sad.
Retarded.
It's so depressing.
All right.
Sometimes we just pass people through because they can dunk a basketball.
Yep. All right. Let's get out of here.
All right. Off our soapbox.
We'll see you later.
Back to the world, everybody. Enjoy it. See you back here next week.
Same old show.